हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस ऑन द फिजिकल मेथड्स ऑफ आईपीएम और इंटीग्रेटेड पेस्ट मैनेजमेंट। इन लास्ट टू वीडियोस वी हैव बीन सीन अबाउट द डिफरेंट कल्चरल एंड मैकेनिकल प्रैक्टिसेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस टू प्रैक्टिसेस आल्सो कॉल्ड एज इको फ्रेंडली प्रैक्टिसेस। With the help of these two practices, how we can suppress or reduce the pest population in our field. Now, in this, we can use a different physical methods or physical way to it will helps to reduce the pest population in our fields, godowns or warehouses also. Okay. Then these are the different tools of IPM, and in that tools today we will discuss on the physical methods of integrated pest management. Here now it is also the one of the, we can say that, the eco-friendly methods of the IPM. Because eco-friendly, it means that we can say there is no use of the chemicals in this methods, hence known as the eco-friendly methods. So what is actually physical methods of the IPM? With the help of the various physical forces or physical factors of the environment, we can eradicate the different pest population in our area or in our field. Okay, it means that manipulation of the different physical factors or physical forces of the environment that will help to reduce the pest population. Let us see one by one. Here, these are the major seven practices we can follow in physical control. In that, the first one is application of heat or temperature manipulation. Then application of cold, then manipulation of moisture, then radioactivity, manipulation of soil, manipulation of light, and use of sound energy. These seven practices, it will be helps to reduce the pest population in our field. Let us see one by one. This is the first practice. The name is application of heat or temperature manipulation. Here we can use a different high lethal temperature. That high lethal temperature, it is very harmful to different insect pest population, and it will be reduced. What happened in this case? The first technique, heating of empty godowns above 50 degrees centigrade to kill the hibernating store grain pest. It means that this high lethal temperature technique, it is mainly or mostly used to control the store grain pest. Then exposing of seeds to natural sunlight by artificial heating kills the eggs or larvae of store products. Okay. Flamethrowers. In last mechanical controls, we have been seen about the flamethrowers, and the flamethrowers, it is mostly used to kill the adults of locust. The next technique is vapor heat treatment. This vapor heat treatment, it is mainly used in a mango to reduce the infestation of fruit fly. Then if you the cotton seeds is exposed to 52 degrees centigrade for 5 minutes, the hibernating larvae of the pink bollworm are killed, because the larvae of the pink bollworm, it is hibernate in the seeds of the cotton for near about 6 to 8 months, and this high temperature, high lethal temperature techniques, it will help to reduce the or to kill the larvae that is present in the seeds or hibernating in that seeds. Then hot water treatment. This treatment, it is mainly used in a rice seeds, and this technique, it is effective against the white tip nematode, and that nematode very severely infests the rice seeds. Let us see one by one. Here, this is the flamethrower. In that flamethrower, with the help of this flamethrower, we can release the heat, very high heat, and with the help of this heat, it will be kill the adult of locust or hoppers of locust. Then this is the sun drying techniques, and these sun drying techniques, it will be used by the farmers after the harvesting of the crops, and these drying techniques helps to reduce the infestation of the store grain pest. Then in this picture, the hot water treatment of the rice seeds, it is helps to reduce the infestation of white tip nematode. Then this is the vapor heat treatment. This treatment used in the mango at the time of storage condition, and at the time of storage condition, it will be helps to reduce the fruit flies infestation. The next technique is application of cold. Here, application of cold, it means that we can say that the reduce the temperature with the help of this because many of the insects, when you reduce the temperature, it will not be survive well or it will be killed. So the nowadays the cold storage facility is available for this purpose. And with the help of this cold storage facility, if you store this potato in the cold storage, it will help to reduce the attack of potato tuber moth, because the potato tuber moth, it is the major pest or major storage pest at the time of storage of the potato. Then refrigeration at 5 to 10 degrees centigrade of edibles products including dry fruits will kill the different insect pests. Then many insects fail to multiply below 10 degrees centigrade. This cold storage facility of fruits and vegetables, it will also help to kill the fruit flies, and the temperature required for the cold storage for fruits and vegetables, it is 1 to 2 degree centigrade. The next technique is manipulation of moisture. This is a very simple technique. If you drying of seed below the critical moisture level below 8% affect the insect survival that damage the store product. It means that when after the harvesting of the different cereal products of pulses or oil seed, it will be sun drying, and to maintain the moisture below 8%, it will be helps to reduce the pest population of the store grain. Then alternate drying and wetting of the paddy fields to reduce the brown plant hopper population also. Then next is radioactivity. Here, with the help of high frequency radio waves, we can sterilize the male insects, and that male insect, it will be released into the environment, that male insect it copulating with the females, and it will, that female produce a unfertilized eggs and reduce the pest population. What happened in this case? The high frequency radio waves generate about 80 degree centigrade temperature in grains to kill the weevils. The gamma rays are produced by the cobalt 60 more used to control or in control the store grain pest. It means that this gamma rays, cobalt 60, it will be very helpful to reduce the store grain pest in the store products. Male insect can make the sterile by the gamma radiation. When such sterile male release in normal insect population compete with the normal males copulating the females, and to that extent the reproductive capacity of the population is reduced. It means that the sterility is produced with the help of this gamma radiation or high frequency radio waves. Use of radiations to kill or to sterilize the insects and make them unfit for mating and reproduction. For example, the gamma radiation is used to kill the internal store pest when the pest or when the grains are exposed to the gamma radiation. Then the sterile technique is successful in the cattle skewer by using the gamma radiation from the cobalt 60. Okay, this is all about the radioactive activities or high frequency radio waves helps to reduce the pest population. And in this picture you can see this is the radio frequency instrument, and this is the infrared radiation instrument that will help to increase the temperature above near around 80 degrees centigrade, and with the help of this radiation we can make the insects unfit for their mating and their reproduction. Then this is another instrument, that is a UV radiation instrument and ionizing radiation instrument. This infrared radiation instrument, it will be helps to reduce the rice weevil population. And here also we can say that this is the yellow color attract the aphids, and black colors attract angiomyces grain moth also. Then ionizing radiations like gamma ray, with the help of gamma ray, it will be kills to sterile the many insects and reduce the pest population. Then another technique is manipulation of soil. Here in this picture we can see this is the technique of manipulation of soil. What happened here? This is the technique of the soil steam sterilization or soil steaming. It is the one of the technique is a farming technique that sterilize the soil with the steam in open field or greenhouse also. It will help to reduce the pest of the plants such as insects, weeds, bacteria, fungi and viruses are killed through induced hot steam in our field or in greenhouse also. The next soil manipulation technique is that soil solarization. This is a very simple technique. In the summer or in the May month, with the help of these transparent polythene sheets, we can cover our field or soils. And this, we can say that near about 15 to 20 days, we can cover these soils in the hot summer month, and it will be increase the soil temperature, and it will help to reduce the different pest population which is present in our field. Okay. The next technique is sound energy. With the help of this sound technique, we can repel the different insect pest population from our source. What happen here? Acoustic devices like a bird scarer, acetylene explorer produce sudden loud sound which is frighten the birds. Then firecrackers is also used to make the loud sound to scatter away squirrel, foxes, rats, mice and deer also. Okay, this is the sound technique. Then manipulation of light. In last lecture we have seen about the light trap. This light trap is nothing but the one of the best example of the manipulation of light. What happened here? This, with the help of this manipulation of light, it serves many purposes: monitoring initial infestation, seasonal incidence, pest weather relationship, pest intensity, pest survey, mass trapping and killing of the adults of the nocturnal insect pest. It means that there are the number of purpose of the manipulation of light, or with the help of light trap, with the help of this purposes or technique, we can reduce the pest population in our field. What happened in light trap? Insect light trap is one of the very effective tools of insect pest management, as it mass trap both sexes of insect pest population and also substantially reduce the carryover stage of the pest population. It works great for monitoring pest infestation by catching flying insects. The blue lamps are specifically designed to emit light at the ultraviolet wavelength. Light source may include fluorescent lamp, mercury vapor lamp, black lights or light emitting diodes. Design differ according to the behavior of the insects being targeted. Light traps are widely used to survey nocturnal moth. It means that here the light trap is nothing but the one of the effective tools in the pest management. What happened? It helps to attract the both sexes of the nocturnal insects. There are the number of the light resources or light sources we can use, maybe fluorescent lamp. This fluorescent lamp which will be helps to attract the different pest population in night hours. And there is one yellow color lamp is also there, that yellow color lamp which is increase the temperature that surrounding area, and when the insect attracted toward that fluorescent bulbs, and due to the high temperature it will be dropped down into the bags which is present at the bottom. What is the main purpose of the light manipulation in the pest management? The first one is mating frequency reduction in the red hairy caterpillar, then reduce the fertility in the Indian male moth, and diapause disruption, that all diaposing insects. It means that this is the main three purpose of the light trap. With the help of these purposes, which will be install this light trap in our field to reduce the pest population. And then this is this some of the light trap example. The first one is solar light trap, then the next two is the electric light trap. This light trap we can install in our field to attract the different nocturnal moth population. This technique, it is very effective in a tomato to attract the pinworm insects. Then also in case of store grain products, this light trap we can also install in our godowns to attract the rice moth and Indian meal moth also. Then these are the some of the other practices also we can use in physical control to attract the different pest population. In that, the first technique is, this is a new technique, that is modified atmosphere techniques. In that techniques, the concentration of carbon dioxide is increased in warehouse and godowns, and store pest killed due to the asphyxiation. Asphyxiation, from it means that the removal of the ears. It means that it reduce or it make the environment or make that environment of the godowns, which means that it create the anaerobic conditions, and that anaerobic condition helps to reduce the pest population. This is the modified atmosphere technique. Then coating up store grains with vegetable oils to prevent the adult opossum beetle from egg laying, as the grain is slippery and abdomen of the beetles slip. It means that just simple, at the time of storage of the pulse grains, this pulse grain, it should be coated with vegetable oils, and with the help of these vegetable oils, it will helps to reduce the egg laying capacity or egg laying of the pulse beetle, because the pulse beetle, it is the major pest of pulses. The next is simply the mixing of inner dust for seed purpose. At the time of storage of the different grains, we can mix the different inner dust like clay and ash. Also, we can add the silica gel or kaolinic clay. What happen when you mix this clay or ash or silica gel with the stored grains, which absorb by the cuticle by the insect, which absorb the cuticle, which absorb by insect cuticle, by which insect lose their body moisture and die due to the desiccation. Means okay, then this is the use of sticky traps. Nowadays in market various sticky traps is available. It may be yellow sticky trap or it may be blue sticky trap. This sticky trap are the glue based trap, okay, and this all the both yellow and blue sticky trap, it is mostly used to attract the sucking pest like a aphids, jacids, thrips, white fly, mealybug, scale insect, and also to attract the different flies and leaf miner. Also this sticky trap, it is good for only 30 days, and then after 30 days we can replace the sticky trap in a new one. The blue sticky trap, it is mostly used to attract the thrips only. Okay, in this picture we can see these are the different sticky trap. Yellow and blue sticky trap. Blue sticky trap mostly to attract the thrips, and we can install in our greenhouse or foil house or in a field also by alternate way. The first is yellow, then blue, yellow, then blue. In this way, we can install this sticky trap in our field to attract the different sucking pest population. Then this is also the another different traps. The first one is a water trap, also called as water trap. This water trap, it is mostly used to attract the brinjal shoot and fruit borer. This brinjal shoot and fruit borer, it is the one of the major pest of the brinjal. When you install this trap in brinjal crop cultivation, the adult or the male adult of this brinjal shoot and fruit borer attract toward these lures, and we can kill in this kerosene and water or pesticide solution. Next one is a fruit fly trap. This fruit fly trap, it is very effective against the all the fruit fly species. It is mostly used in cucurbit crops and all fruit crops nearabout. Then delta sticky traps. The delta sticky traps is also used against the different flies and leaf miners also. Next one is a fish meal trap. This techniques or this trap, it is mostly used against the different shoot fly and stem fly species in the cereal crops. Then this is the sex pheromone trap. This sex pheromone trap, it is the funnel shaped sex pheromone trap, and the purpose of the installation of this sex pheromone trap in our field, it is only used for mass trapping, monitoring and mass dispersion purpose. Okay, this sex pheromone trap we can install in our field just above, just 2 feet just above the our plant height or crop height. This sex pheromone trap or funnel shaped trap, it is mostly effective against the Lepidopteran moth or Lepidopteran insects. Then which are the different merits and demerits of the physical control? It gives immediate results. This is the merits. Then these methods are generally popular and believable to the farmers. Insects are killed by the physical action, hence environmentally safe. It means that this technique, it is eco-friendly techniques. Then what about demerits? These methods are time consuming and costly, and these methods are very used. Why this method is costly? Because there are the number of the mechanical devices which will be used for manipulation of the different physical factors. That device is very costly. These methods are useful when there is much more damage has been done, or it means that the population is more. A special equipment is required for heating and refrigeration. Okay, this is all about the all the physical methods we can use in our integrated pest management to reduce the pest population in our field. Okay, thank you.